Hello students, today's class we are going to discuss numerical problems from the sound chapter. So in the sound chapter, what are all the expressions we have studied? V is equal to F lambda. This is the relation connecting wave velocity, frequency and wavelength. The second expression is when you are hearing a sound, that is when you are hearing an echo, after the sound gets reflected from an obstacle, the speed of sound in the medium is determined by the expression V is equal to 2D by T. In this expression, D represents the distance of separation between the source and the obstacle. T is the time for hearing an echo. V is the speed of sound in the medium. Then the relation connecting the frequency and the time period is F is equal to 1 by T, where T represents the time period. F represents the frequency of sound. Yes, and all the letters we have used in the expression, I have written here, written the what each letter represents and its SI unit. V represents velocity, its SI unit is meter per second. F represents frequency, SI unit is hertz. Lambda represents wavelength, whose SI unit is meter. T represents time period, whose SI unit is second. Okay. For all the questions, you refer the textbook. Okay, sound chapter, first unit, 7A. The first question, the wavelength of waves produced on the surface of water is 20 centimeter. If the wave velocity is 24 meter per second, calculate the number of waves produced in 1 second and the time in which one wave is produced. So first we have to write the data. Read the question. What is given? Write the data. First one they have given, the wavelength is given. Okay, the wavelength of the wave is given as lambda is equal to 20 centimeter. The wavelength is represented by the symbol lambda, which is given as 20 centimeter. The SI unit of wavelength is meter. So we have to convert centimeter into meter. 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. So 20 centimeter is equal to 20 into 10 power minus 2 meter. Then the speed of sound in the medium is given as, that is wave velocity is 24 meter per second. The question it is given, if the wave velocity is 24 meter per second, that is the wave velocity V is equal to 24 meter per second. And you are asked to calculate the number of waves produced in 1 second. The number of waves produced in 1 second is called as the frequency. So you are asked to calculate frequency. The expression for frequency is F is equal to V by lambda. From the data, substitute for V and lambda. V is equal to 20 into 10 power minus 2 meter and lambda is equal to, V is equal to 24 meter per second. Lambda is equal to 20 into 10 power minus 2 meter. Yes. And 10 power minus 2, when you take it to the numerator, it becomes 10 power plus 2, which can be written as 100. 10 square is 100 divided by 20. On simplification, we will get 120. The SI unit of frequency is hertz. Okay. So, we can write F is equal to 120 hertz. In the question, they have asked the number of waves produced in 1 second. So, if you write the number of waves produced in 1 second, you have to write the answer as 120. If you write it as frequency, you write it as 120 hertz. Okay. So, number of waves produced in 1 second is equal to 120. Number of waves produced is mere number. When you write it as frequency, write the unit as hertz. Next, you are asked to calculate the time in which one wave is produced. The relation connecting time and the frequency is T is equal to 1 by F, which is equal to 1 by F is equal to 1 by 20. On simplification, you will get T is equal to 0.0083 second and which can be written as 8.3 into 123. 3 decimal place you are placing the this one. So, 10 power minus 3 second. So, time T is equal to 8.3 into 10 power minus 3 second. You can write it as 0.0083 second also. Nothing is wrong in that. Okay. Next question. Calculate the minimum distance in air required between the source of sound and the obstacle to hear an echo. Take speed of sound in air is equal to 350 meter per second. So the speed of sound in air is given as 350 meter per second. So V is equal to 350 meter per second. Next, it is given. You are asked to calculate the minimum distance in air, the obstacle to hear an echo. So, to hear an echo, the minimum distance, the minimum time lag between the original sound and the echo to be heard, or the persistence of our hearing is equal to 0.1 second. The time is not given in this question directly, but they have given that you are asked to calculate the minimum distance, that is the distance between the source and the obstacle, to hear an echo. So to hear an echo, the time, the least distance, that is the persistence of hearing time is equal to t is equal to 0.1 second. If the time taken for you to hear an echo, the between the original sound and the echo should be equal to 0.1 second, then only we can hear the sound, because the ear will perceive the sound for 0.1 second. So as the word hear an echo is given, that will make you decide that time t is equal to 0.1 second, which is the persistence of our hearing. Okay. Next, you are asked to calculate the distance, minimum distance between the source and the obstacle. So the distance, the expression is equal, d is equal to Vt by 2. Substitute for V as 350 and T as 0.1 divided by 2. 350 into 0.1 is equal to 35 divided by 2, which is equal to 17.5 meter. So D is equal to 17.5 meter. Yes. Next, come to the third question. What should be the minimum distance between the source and the reflector in water so that the echo is heard distinctly? The speed of sound in water is given as 1400 meter per second. So in this question, the speed of sound in water is given as V is equal to 1400 meter per second. Next one. Again, this question also similar to the previous one. Time is not given. Echo is heard distinctly. To hear an echo distinctly, time we have to substitute as the persistence, that is the time between the original sound and the echo to be heard should be equal to 0.1 second, or the persistence of our ears is equal to 0.1 second. You have to substitute. Again, D is equal to, this sum is similar to the second problem. Same expression, D is equal to Vt by 2. V is 1400. T is 0.1, that is time, divided by 2. This is, which is equal to 140 divided by 2, which is equal to 70 meter. So the minimum distance between the source and the reflector in water should be equal to 70 meter. Come to the fourth question. A man standing 25 meter away from a wall produces a sound and receives the reflected sound. Calculate the time after which he receives the reflected sound if the speed of sound in air is 350 meter per second. Yes. Here we draw the diagram. Man, let's consider this as the wall. And the man is standing 25 meters away from the wall. The distance between the man and the wall is equal to 25 meter. Yes. So we write the data. The distance between the source and the obstacle is equal to 25 meter. The speed of sound in the medium is given as 350 meter per second. V is equal to 350 meter per second. You are asked to calculate the time. The expression for time t is equal to 2d by v. That is 2 into 25, d value is 25, divided by v is equal to 350, which is equal to 50 by 350, which is equal to 1 by 7. On simplification, we get 0.1428 second. So time t is equal to 0.1428 second. Yes. The same question, one more question is asked. Will the man be able to hear a distinct echo? Okay. For hearing a distinct echo, the minimum distance between the source and the obstacle should be equal to 70 meter, provided the speed of sound in the medium is 330 meter per second, and also the medium should be air. Yes. And here the medium is air, it is given, but the distance is given. So from the time only we have to decide, because the time, it should be equal to 0.1 second. That is, the persistence of hearing is equal to 0.1 for hearing a clear echo is 0.1 second. Here the answer is, it is greater than 0.1 second. We have obtained the answer as t is equal to 0.1428 second, which is greater than 0.1 second. So he will be able to hear an echo. So your answer should be yes, he can hear an echo. The reason for the answer is because the t value we have obtained is greater than 0.1 second. 0.1 second is the persistence for of the ears. So the value obtained is here greater than 0.1 second. So he will be able to hear an echo. Okay. Next, fifth question. A radar sends a signal to an aeroplane at a distance 300 kilometer away with a speed of 3×10⁸ meter per second. After how much time is the signal received back after reflecting from the aeroplane? Okay. In this question, the speed is given as, speed d is given as 300 kilometer, SI unit of distance is meter, so 300×10³ meter. The speed is given as 3×10⁸ meter per second, and you are asked to calculate the time. The expression for time t is 2d/v, which is equal to 2×300×10³ divided by, the value of v is 3×10⁸, right, which is equal to 3 and 3, you can cancel, so you will get 2×100, and 10⁸ and 10³, if you cancel here, you will get 10⁵. Take it to the numerator, see here, 3 and 3, if you cancel, 2×100 you will have. 10⁸, you take it to the numerator, it becomes 10⁻¹. But here 3+2, 5 you have. So 5 - 8 is equal to 10⁻³. Yeah. So the time t is equal to 2×10⁻³ second. So here you are asked to calculate after how much time is the signal received back after reflecting from the aeroplane. The time taken will be equal to 2×10⁻³ second. Come to the sixth question. A man standing 48 meter away from a wall fires a gun. Calculate the time after which an echo is heard. The speed of sound in air is given as 320 meter per second. So this one, the distance is given, the distance between the person and the wall is given as 48 meter, and the speed of sound in the medium is given as 320 meter per second. You are asked to calculate the time. So time t is equal to 2d/v. Substitute for d and v from the data. D is 48 and v is equal to 320, which is equal to, on cancellation you will get 6 8s are 48, 4 8s are 32, which is equal to 12/40. 12/40 is equal to 3 4s are 12 and 10 4s are 40, which is equal to 0.3 second. So the time t is equal to 0.3 second. Yes. Come to the seventh question. A ship on the surface of water sends a signal sends a signal and receives it back from a submarine inside water after 4 seconds. Calculate the distance of the submarine from the ship. The speed of sound in water is 1450 meter per second. So here the time is given as 4 seconds and the speed of sound in water is given as meter per second, and you are asked to calculate the distance. Okay, so distance d is equal to vt by 2, which is equal to 1450 into 4 divided by 2. Yes, which is equal to 1450 into 2, which is equal to 2900 meter. So d is equal to 2900 meter. See the book answer, they have given it as 2.9 kilometer, but always you are expected to give the answer in SI unit. Yes, so keep the answer in meter only, not don't convert it into kilometer. Next question, 8th one. A pendulum has a frequency of 5 vibrations per second. An observer starts the pendulum and fires a gun simultaneously. He hears echo from the cliff after 8 vibrations of the pendulum. If the velocity of sound in air is 340 meter per second, find the distance between the cliff and the observer. In this question, speed is given directly. But the time for hearing an echo is not given directly. Instead of that, they have given in terms of vibration. See the first statement, a pendulum has a frequency of 5 vibrations per second. That means the time taken by the pendulum to complete 5 vibrations is equal to 1 second. So that I write it, that is time taken for 5 vibration is equal to 1 second. That's the first statement. The time taken for 5 vibration is equal to 1 second. From this we can calculate the time taken for 1 vibration. Yes. So the time taken for 1 vibration is equal to 1 by 5 second. Yes. Next one. Here instead of giving the time for hearing the echo, it is given, he hears echo from the cliff after 8 vibrations of the pendulum. That is the time is given in terms of vibration. So I can write, the time taken for the for hearing an echo is 8 vibrations. 1 vibration is equal to 1 by 5 second. So 8 vibration is equal to 8 into 1 by 5 second. Yes, this is the way you have to calculate the time. Then normal substitution. Distance d is equal to vt by 2. V is given as 340 meter per second. Yes, v is equal to 340 meter per second. Into t, in the place of t you have to substitute 8 into 1 by 5. Yes, the whole divided by v into t divided by 2. So which is equal to 340 into 8 divided by 2 into 5. 2 5s are 10. So you will get 34 into 8. 34 into 8 is equal to 4 8s are 32, remaining 3, 3 8s are 24, 24 plus 3, 27, 272 meter. So d is equal to 272 meter. Yes. So in this question, only difference is the time is not given directly, it is given in terms of vibrations. So you calculate the time, convert vibrations into time in second, then substitute in the expression. Come to the 9th question. A person standing between two vertical cliffs produces a sound. Two successive echoes are heard at 4 seconds and 6 seconds. Calculate the distance between the cliffs. Speed of sound in air is given as 320 meter per second. First we draw the diagram. 9th question. A person standing between two vertical cliffs. We consider this as one cliff. This I write it as cliff 1. This I write it as cliff 2. and the person is standing between the two cliffs. Yes. Let me take the distance between the man and the first cliff be D1. The distance between the man and the second cliff be D2. Okay. The distance between the man and the first cliff is D1. The distance between the man and the second cliff is D2. So the time taken by the person to hear an echo from the first cliff be T1, which is given as 4 seconds T1. And the time taken to hear an echo from the second cliff, I take it as T2. The question itself, it is given 2 successive echoes are heard, 4 seconds and 6 seconds. Definitely the 4 second echo should be from the nearest cliff. And the second one should be from the second one, that is the second cliff is away from, that is the distance of the second cliff from the first cliff is more. So the time taken to hear an echo from the second cliff will be more. So that should be taken as 6 seconds. Okay. If I take D1 is the distance between the first cliff and the person, then T1 is the time taken to hear an echo. As the first cliff is near to him than the second cliff, the time taken to hear an echo from the first cliff will be less than the time taken to hear an echo from the second cliff. So that T1 I should take it as 4 seconds. And T2 should be equal to 6 seconds. Okay. Now, if I take, let D be the distance between the two cliffs. Let D be the distance between the two vertical cliffs. Then I can write the given, the speed of sound in the air is given as 320 meter per second. I write the data. D1 and D2 are not given. T1 is given as 4 seconds. And T2 is given as 6 seconds. The expression for speed is V is equal to 2D1 by T1. Here also the medium is the same. So 2D2 by T2. Yes. And this expression and this expression, if you see, both are expressions for sound. This I take it as 1. This I take it as 2. Equation 1 and expression 2, if you observe, both are expression for speed of sound in air. Yes. So I can substitute in this one. 320 is equal to 2 into D1 by T1 is equal to 4. From this, D1 is equal to 4 into 320 divided by 2. On simplification 2, here 2 2s are 4. 0, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. 640 meter. Again for D2 I substitute. D2 is equal to 2 is equal to VT2 by 2. That is V is equal to D2 is equal to VT2 by 2. V is equal to 320. T2 is equal to 6 divided by 2. So 2 and this one, if I cancel, you will get 3, which is equal to 3. 3 2s are 6. 3 3s are 9. 960 meter. D1 is equal to 640 meter. D2 is equal to 960 meter. D1 is the distance between the person and the cliff. D2 is the distance between the person and the second cliff. In the question, you are asked to calculate the distance between the cliffs. The distance between the cliffs, if I take it as D, then the distance between the cliff D is equal to distance between the person and the first cliff plus the distance between the person and the second cliff, which is D2. D1 plus D2, D1 is equal to 640 meter, D2 is equal to 960 meter, which is equal to 1600 meter. So the distance between the two cliffs is equal to 1600 meter. Yes. Come to the next question. This is the 10th question. A person standing at a distance X in front of a cliff fires a gun. Another person B standing behind the person A at distance Y from the cliff hears two sounds of the fired shot after 2 seconds and 3 seconds respectively. Calculate X and Y. take speed of sound as 320 meter per second. First we draw the diagram. A person standing at a distance x in front of the cliff. So first I draw the cliff. This is the cliff. This is the position of the person. This is the cliff. A person standing at a distance x in front of a cliff fires a gun. Another person, so this person is A, he is standing in front of the cliff and he is at a distance x from the cliff. It is given in the question. Okay, now another person B standing behind the person A. Another person B is standing behind him. Write it as B. And behind the person A at a distance y from the cliff. So he is at a distance y from the cliff. The distance between the cliff and the second person is y. Yes. Cliff. He has two sounds of a fired shot after 2 seconds and 3 seconds. That is 2 seconds is the he is getting, that is when the person A is firing the gun, B will be getting directly from the person A, directly from the gun. That is not an echo. As A is firing the gun, B will be getting the sound of the fired gun directly from him. So this, the time taken to hear the sound from A, that is the gun fired by A, is heard by B at a time interval of 2 seconds. It is a direct sound. So this time I take it as t is equal to 2 seconds. Okay. Next one, he is getting 3 seconds respectively. That is 3 seconds is the reflected sound. That is 2 seconds and 3 seconds. So the time taken for him to hear an echo from the cliff is equal to 3 seconds. Okay. That I take it as ty is equal to 3 plus 2, which is equal to 5 seconds. That is, the distance of the second person from the cliff is y. So, the time taken taken by him to hear an echo at a distance of y is equal to 3 plus 2. Because 2 is the direct one. That is, the time taken for the sound to travel this distance. 3 is the time taken by the sound to go from the fired gun, reaches the cliff, it gets reflected, then reaching him. That is 3 seconds. So 3 plus 2 is equal to 5 seconds. Okay. Now here the speed of sound is given as 320 meter per second. So you have to write here the sound heard by B at t, that is the sound heard by B directly from A is equal to 2 seconds. And we can write the speed of sound for this expression, we can write, that is the sound heard by B at a time interval of t is equal to 2 seconds. The speed I write it as d by t because it is not an echo. Velocity is equal to distance by time. It is not an echo. The sound is traveling just from A to B. Yes, directly from A to B. So the speed of sound for this one is equal to v is equal to d by t. General formula. Here the distance is equal to distance. Here the distance we have to calculate. So this distance we can take it as d is equal to v into t. Speed of sound is given as 320. And the time taken by B to hear the sound directly from A is equal to 2, which is equal to 640 meter. Yes. So the distance between A and B is equal to 640 meter. So that I write it as d. D is equal to 640 meter. That is the distance between A and B. This distance is equal to D, which is equal to 640 meter. Now this distance is X. Okay. So X plus D is equal to Y. D is the distance between A and B. X is the distance between the cliff and A. So X plus D will give me Y because in the question it is given the person B is at a distance y from the cliff. Yes. So y is equal to x plus d. From this I can write x is equal to y minus d. So x is equal to y we have to calculate. Y we can calculate by y is equal to v ty by 2. Why I am writing ty? T is the time taken by B to hear the sound due to echo. Yes, which is equal to speed is 320. Ty, the time taken to hear an echo, is equal to 5 seconds. 5 divided by 2. On simplification, you will get 160 into 5. 160 into 5, which is equal to 800 meter. Right? Y is equal to 800 meter. This y you substitute here. Y is equal to 800. D is equal to 640. So, x is equal to 160 meter. Yes? This question, you have to be very clear with the question. The person A is firing the gun. B is standing behind him, is hearing two sounds, that is two sounds. One is a 2 second, the other one 3 seconds. Okay, so the 2 second is the direct sound which he is getting from the gun, and 3 seconds after this one is the sound, the reflected sound what he is getting. So the reflected sound is, first the sound from the gun fired by A reaches the cliff, it gets reflected and reaching P. Am I right? So this time is 3 and this time is 2. So 3 plus 2 is equal to 5 seconds. Okay. So first one we are calculating what is the distance between A and B. But B is getting the direct sound. So it is not an echo. Then expression for speed is equal to distance by time. From this, distance is equal to speed into time. Speed is given as 320. Time is given as 2 seconds. So 320 into 2 is equal to 640 meter. That is, the distance between A and B is equal to 640 meter. Yes. Next one, the distance between the cliff and the person B is Y. Yes. The time taken by B to get the sound, the reflected sound from the cliff, is equal to 5 seconds. So Y is equal to V TY by 2. That is the time taken to hear an echo from the cliff. Okay. The distance is Y. So I have taken it as TY. So, VTY by 2 is equal to 320 into 5 divided by 2. So, Y is equal to 800 meter, where Y represents the distance between the cliff and the person B. Okay. But in the question, you are asked to calculate. So, why you are asked to calculate? You are asked to calculate the distance between A and the cliff. For that, the diagram, if you see that, the distance between the person and the cliff, the distance between the person and person A and B is D. So x plus d is equal to y, where y is the distance between the cliff and the person. Okay, so we know y, we know the distance between the two persons and the distance between the second person and the cliff. From there, using these two, we are going to calculate the distance between the person A and the cliff. So x plus d is equal to y. So x is equal to y minus d. That will give you x. Substitute for y, substitute for d, you will get the value of x, where x represents the distance between the person A and the cliff. Y will give you the distance between the person B and the cliff. Right? Next, 11th question. On sending an ultrasonic wave from a ship towards the bottom of a sea, the time interval between sending the wave and receiving it back is found to be 1.5 seconds. If the velocity of wave in sea water is 1400 meter per second, find the depth of the sea. So this is the direct question. T is equal to, time is given as 1.5 second. The speed is given as 1400 meter per second. You are asked to calculate the distance. Expression for D is Vt by 2, which is equal to 1400 into 1.5 divided by 2. Which is equal to 700 into 1.5. On multiplication, you will get 1050 meter. So D is equal to 1050 meter. Okay. Come to the next question. 12th question. Here the diagram is given. That is, the displacement time graph is given for two waves A and B. Compare their amplitudes and the wavelength. First, check the wave A. The amplitude of the wave A is, I write the amplitude as A. For the wave A, I have represented A suffix A. Look at the diagram. The amplitude of the wave A is 10 centimeter, right? It is given in centimeter. So 10 centimeter. The amplitude of the wave B is, see in the diagram, which is equal to 5 centimeter. In the question, you are asked to compare their amplitudes. So amplitude of A is to amplitude of B is equal to, amplitude of A is 10, amplitude of B is 5. On simplification, we get 2:1. So the ratio of their amplitude is 2:1. Second one, the wavelength of the two waves. That is, wavelength of the wave A, I take it as lambda A. The wavelength of the wave B, I take it as lambda B. Write the data. Lambda A, look at the diagram. Lambda A is the distance between the successive crest and the trough. So if you consider for the wave A, it is, see in the diagram, the wavelength of A, that is the distance between the crest and the trough for the wave A is equal to up to 8 centimeter. So lambda A is equal to 8 centimeter. For that you have to observe it in the x-axis. Okay, because distance is taken along x-axis. For the wave B, if you see that one full wave, the length is equal to 16 centimeter. So lambda of B is equal to 16 centimeter. Lambda A is to lambda B. Lambda A is equal to 8. Lambda B, that is the wavelength of the wave B, is equal to 16, which is equal to 1:2. So the ratio of their amplitude is 2:1. The ratio of their wavelength is 1:2. Yes. So in this 7A sound chapter exercise, all the numerical problems given in that exercise we have solved. Yes, students. So I want you to go through all these problems, understand, then do it by yourself in the classwork notebook. So when you start to write in the classwork notebook, write the lesson number, name, write these expressions, because only these three expressions we are using it in this in solving the numerical problems of this exercise. V is equal to f lambda, V is equal to 2d by t, frequency is equal to 1 by time period. The side I have written what each letter represents with their SI unit. Yes. So go through all these problems, understand, then do it by yourself in the classwork notebook. Do all these sums in the classwork notebook. For questions, you refer the textbook. Okay. Thank you, students.